Hi, this is Jaya. Now we shall see the summary of The Bishop's Candlestick by Norman Macdonald. Come, let's go to the story. Norman Macdonald is a Scottish stage and film actor, and he is also a very famous playwright, and he has also acted in Alfred Hitchcock's Downhill movie. And this The Bishop's Candlestick is a one-act play, and it is an adaptation of Victor Hugo's novel Les Miserables. The beginning of the story itself shows the character of the bishop. The bishop is a very kind-hearted and a noble man. He is very generous, and we find his sister Pesome talking to the servant maid Maria, and she keeps talking about the bishop's generosity and how people are misusing him. And she asks Maria for the silver salt cellars to keep it on the table, and Maria tells her that she has sold them. So she shouts at her, saying, "How can you sell it without my permission?" And Maria says, no, the bishop only asked me to sell." And so Maria goes on doing her work, and Pesome starts scolding her brother, thinking that his generous nature is only leading people to misuse him. And he has already sold his estate, his furniture, and also spent all his savings for others. At that time, the bishop enters the home, and he asks Maria to go home to take care of her mother, who is very sick. And Pesome talks to her brother, and she says that you should not be so very generous towards others. And she even makes fun of him, saying that maybe one day you will even give up this candlesticks, which is a gift by his dying mother. And the bishop does not answer anything to her, and they have their dinner, and Pesome goes to bed, and the bishop sits reading a book. At midnight, what happens is a convict. Convict means a person who was arrested and kept in the prison, who has escaped, is called a convict. He comes there, and he holds a knife near the bishop and threatens him. But the bishop is not frightened, and he is very calm. And the bishop asks him, "What does the thief want?" And then the thief says, "I want some food." So the bishop goes and calls his sister Pesome and asks her to prepare food for him. And he treats the thief very kindly and provides him a cold pie, wine, and bread to eat. And afterwards, the thief starts talking to the bishop, and he says that his wife was very sick. His wife Janet, she was very sick, and in order to give her some food, he did not have money, so he stole a loaf of bread. And for that, he was arrested, and he was put in jail for 10 years. And he says that in jail, he experienced the worst kind of treatment. Like, he was chained and he was lashed. It was hell to him. And his number was 15729. That was the number which was given to him in the jail. And now he has escaped from the prison. And he says that people, even wherever he went, they treated him very badly, and he is not even able to think of any way of survival. And then he asks the bishop why the doors of his house were not closed. And then the bishop says, "No, I never close the door. It is always open. Anyone can come in at any time." And he says that this is the first time in 30 years I had to close the door in order to protect you. And then afterwards, bishop prepares the bed for him and asks him to go to sleep. That time the convict sees the silver candlelights, and the bishop notices him seeing it, and he says that these are the present of my mother before she could part away, that is before she could die. And then he asks him to sleep, and he goes away. Though the thief knows that it is the gift of bishop's mother to the bishop, and he realizes that the bishop has been very kind to him, he is not able to keep away. He steals the candlesticks and he runs away. Next morning, Pesome and bishop find that the candlesticks are missing, and as they are talking, a sergeant enters with three soldiers and the convict. They have seen the convict walking in the road with the candlesticks, and they have arrested him on the suspension, and they have identified the candlesticks as that of the bishop's. And so they were they have brought the convict there. And what happens is the bishop, understanding the convict's position, and he knows that he has already suffered a lot in the jail, he says that the convict is his friend and he only gifted the candlesticks to the man. The police, they could not do anything because the bishop himself has said that I gifted it to the convict. So they leave him and go. And this kindness of the bishop moves the convict so much, because he knows very well that the candlesticks were presented to the, were given to the bishop by his mother, and he has stolen that. But to save the convict from going to the jail, the bishop has told him like that. Then afterwards, the bishop tells him to keep the candlesticks as a gift itself. And he tells you can go to Paris. He shows him the road to the Paris also. He says if you go there, you can live a better life there. And he gives him a message. He says that the body of the man is the temple of God. And he asks him to remember this always. And the convict is moved by the message, and he promises to lead a honest life in Paris and leaves the place. This is actually a Christian message which is being conveyed in the story, and it is a very, very popular story. I hope you liked the video. Please like it, share it with your friends, and if you're not subscribed my channel, please subscribe. And while subscribing, please don't forget to press the bell icon. Only then you'll get the notification of all the videos I'm posting. Thank you.